Wouldn't it be great if we all had that superpower where inside we could be feeling like, why? Why did you leave me, bro? We were so good together. But outside we'd be like, oh, it's fine, it's completely fine. Nothing, don't worry about it. Hey, you doing all right? How you doing? Good? Or we could be really mad at someone, like, I wanna get his throat and just strangle the last atom of oxygen out of him. And outside you're like, hey, what's up, man? You're looking nice. Good shirt. What about it? But we don't have that, do we? Not always can we manage that emotional energy to deal with people without showing them what's going on inside. And that's a huge, huge, huge skill to have. It's also a very important skill for leaders to give that kind of positive energy outside in the world without taking them inside your sorrows or your regrets. Before we go any further into this matter, I want to clarify one thing. Emotional intelligence is not just about showing a different emotion than what you're feeling. It's more about being patient, and it's more about understanding the other person who is in that exchange of emotions with you, because that's what emotions are. It's not a one-way street. Emotions are evoked in a certain person, and that emotion sort of ricochets off the other person in the communication process and hits you back, and that's how it goes. So it's more about putting yourself on the other person's shoes and understanding and getting the conversation going. So it's, don't think of it as just like a gun, you know, you shoot emotions at other people. It's more like a two-way street, you know, where it's going both ways. The outcome is going to be a sort of average of all the emotions that have been exchanged. Before this gets any more confusing, let's go talk about a very beautiful quote by Maya Angelou. People will forget what you said and did, but they will never forget how you made them feel. Okay, and this is very important, because what you make people feel, in turn, they make you feel that. So it's sort of like a give and take thing. Some people, they think negative emotions are good. Negative emotions like anger, getting upset, projecting a lot of sadness, you know, showing frustration to someone. It might seem like it's a good idea, and for the short run it's good, but in the long run it actually stresses you out a lot and causes a lot of fatigue in you, and it's really not the most productive way to live your life. And it also creates a bad impression, because people are like, that guy's an asshole, you know. Or maybe if you're too emotional, too sad, too all the upset, all the sulking all the time, they're like, what a sissy, you know. I'm being very frank here, but that's what goes around, and so you need to sort of be on top of your emotions, and you need to understand what the other person is going through and talk to them. You know, this is emotional energy is more about having these conversations, having the awkward conversations, if I may say so. And now let's look at an example.
You guys ready?
Baby, when she stopped laughing, she kept looking at the other baby, and the other baby is laughing, so she again gets into that vibe, and they both start this sort of oscillating laughter thing, and that's really, really cute and interesting, and sort of creates some sort of positive energy in you. So in the workplace, this also goes around in a different manner, of course, but in principle it's the same thing. The more positive you are, the more positive your environment will eventually become.